As it turns out, I guess I'm playing Dark Souls 3 again. I've already beaten the game once, but we're doing it again.
Yes, indeed.
Yes, indeed, we're doing it again.
It is called Lothring, where the transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge. In venturing north, the pilgrims discover the truth of the old words. The fire fades, and the lords go without thrones. Undead Legion, the Abyss Watchers. And the reclusive lord of the profaned capital. Yon the Giant. Kindled will rise. Nameless, accursed undead, unfit even to be cinder. And so it is that ash seeketh embers.
Ah, there we go. Hey guys, welcome to Dark Souls 3. I already kind of know what I'm going to do with my character. I swore to myself I wouldn't have a slightly boring opener, but here we are. I think I'm just going to go with good old Store Noble. Standard. Pro tip for playing Dark Souls at all times. Whenever you have the option to make your character of a color that makes absolutely no sense, please do so. You are really just depriving yourself of the fun if you don't. And in our case, well, we could make him pale as a sheet. That would be very fun. Let's see if we can go with like a grayish. That's too black. There is a good level of black, and that was highly way too much. We could like make him blindingly bright. Like, oh my god, that puts mimes to shame. That's terrifying. I don't want to do that. You can make him a booger. I kind of wanted to go with like a pink shade, maybe. That's what I made my first character, because I had to model him. I modeled him after Morg, because Morg's like a fire guy. So, if you don't know who Morg is, I'm not explaining it, don't ask. Booger color was pretty appealing just for the moment. I swear to God, I won't spend a lot of time on character creation. I'm just getting the basics. There we go! That's the shade of pink I wanted. What about... Ooh, that's a good fleshy color of pink. There we go. That's pretty good. Right there, actually. Like, yeah. That's a disgustingly fleshy color of pink. I like it a lot. Alright, cool. Oh, damn it. Oh, no, okay. I thought I didn't save it for a minute. I was gonna be like, no! Alright. Okay, so base skin color. Let's go with build detail. What kind of, here am I gonna give this guy? Let's go black. Yeah, let's go black. Can I give him an afro? Is there an afro option? That would be awesome, but I don't think so. Damn it. That's sad. There is no afro option. There's... All the options are completely unappealing to me for this sort of thing. I think I should actually switch the gender up. Yeah, I should... Okay, sorry, I need to move my mic back. I need to switch the gender up. I'm gonna do another introduction after this, because... This is all dumb and boring, and I'll end up cutting it out of the YouTube edit. I should have probably done this part off stream, to be completely honest. So we had, like, pink. There we go. That's good. That's a good fleshy color pink. And then we're gonna go, voice. What's an aged voice sound like for this one lovely woman? Okay, that's perfect. And we're gonna, yeah, okay, good, got it. Alright, and then we're gonna go with physique. She's gotta be muscular. We gotta have pecs. Thick body hair, yes. Definitely. Definitely. Can't get around that. Face deal. Oh, she's beautiful. She's a beautiful lady. Despite being horrifically pink. For no explicable reason. As of yet. Don't worry. I'll get to it. Give me a second. Of course, if you can see the stream title, you already know where I'm going with this. You're probably already thinking, Rick, you're gonna get in trouble, and I'm thinking, I don't give a shit. I'll do what I want. Where? Okay. Can I, like, solid... You were, like, creepy solid black eyes, but it's boring. Let's throw... We gotta throw some color in there. Let's see what we can do with that. Baby blue eyes. Nah. Would be a good color. Oh, I fucking know exactly what I want to do with this. Let's take all that shit all the way down. And make those demon red eyes. Yeah, perfect. Oh, this is awesome. What we got for hair options? Okay, what we got for hair options? Beard? Can I give her a... What? What the fuck? I was not expecting that from software. Okay. No, that's progressive. I like it. It's good. I'm down with this. Let's freaking Man, let's just freaking go all the way with it then. Sure. Some thick ass eyelashes and what the fuck? I did not see that coming. That was unexpected. Oh. She is just the spawn of Satan. I love it. That's a round of applause right there. I think I'm gonna go with which one was it? I like the Jesus look. The Jesus look is pretty awesome. I did this one for my last character. I'm gonna go with Jesus. We gotta go with the Jesus. Pink demon Jesus is good for this sort of what we're doing here. You're probably really confused. Okay, well, let me enlighten you if I can with my option of name for pink demon Jesus girl. And so the name is gonna be let me see if I've got enough room for it. Damn it! Just didn't have enough room for it. I think Pink Demon Jesus would almost be good. But I don't think... No, that wouldn't get past the content filter. I'm impressed by the ability for women to have beards in this game. That's actually impressive. I'm really, really happy that's an option. That's super cool. Like, no shit. Invaded by... You were invaded by... Let me see if this fits. Okay, that's not funny. It fits, but it's not funny. Shit. I'm gonna have to come up with another joke for this. And I'm not gonna tell you what the first joke was, because in retrospect, I would have pissed off a lot of people with that name. Probably gotten reported. Fuck. Okay. I got it. Uranus. Or Uranus. Uranus. It's close. Uranus? Nah, it's not funny either. Shit! This is hard. Coming up with jokes is hard. Hang on. I need to abuse Google for this. Jokes about bleeding. Oddly, there aren't as many as I thought there were. God damn it. This is hard. I think I might have to go back to my default. There we go. Bloody Mary! Perfect. Okay. Welcome to Dark Souls. This is where I'll cut to after the intro plays. Because I just did a shit ton of character creation that was boring to look at. Welcome to Dark Souls! Today, I know I skipped Dark Souls 2. I really don't feel like going back and playing it right now. I might later just to show you what it's like, but Dark Souls 3 just came out, and people are still playing it, and it's got shit tons of matchmaking. It doesn't make any sense for me not to play it, while it is still fun to me, so we're gonna play Dark Souls. Bloodborne, do that later. I already know what the fuck I'm doing with Dark Souls. I'm still a little on the best way to go about Bloodborne, but I've got a cool idea for what to do with Dark Souls. So what we're gonna do is perhaps not the most optimal build, but it will be a fun one. I am going to make this character a Luck Hollow Bleed build. And what that is going to do, what that means for you laymen out there, is this character is going to be able to build up bleed really quickly. Hopefully for a shit ton of damage in PvP. But that might run into some problems, because a lot of bosses are immune to bleeding, so I might have trouble with some bosses. But the only hard bosses in this game are the one in like the really late game, so by that point we should have an item that can help us overcome the whole like bosses can't bleed sort of thing, and hopefully by then we'll have it and I won't have as much trouble with those bosses that can't bleed. Boring, I know. Let's go and get into the game before I do any more talking, because otherwise you're gonna be like, oh, by the way, girls can have beards in this game. Progressive. Good job, From Software. Progressive. Excellent choice. Good choice. Great choice. So happy with you, From Software. You're the best. The best for giving girls facial hair. Empowering. Oh my goodness gracious. All right, so shit's happening. Great. I know there's been a drought of content on my channel recently, and I hope this is a way to make it up to you guys and be like, hey, I know I've been busy, but fucking there's reasons for it, and I'll talk about that while we're playing if I run out of other shit to talk about. But This is good. I felt like doing this today on a whim. I got a Turtle Beach headset that is reminiscent of the one I had when I first started doing YouTube videos. Because when I first started doing YouTube videos, I was recording on a Turtle Beach headset plugged into my PC. That's what I recorded the entire BioShock series with. That little bitch was the greatest piece of equipment. Oh, it lasted me an entire 2 years of video making, and it was not a bad device. And I don't think this one's gonna be bad, as long as I can keep it the fuck away from my face and I'm not spitting and into it. It should be just dandy fine. But let's talk about the game we're playing. Miyazaki has made a wonderful spiritual successor to Dark Souls that isn't Dark Souls 2, because Miyazaki didn't make that one, and it probably is why Dark Souls 2 is not loved by the community as much, but somehow loved by Metacritic. I don't know why the fuck you Metacritic guys decided to like Dark Souls 2 so much. That's kind of dumb. You should look at all the scores on Metacritic for all the Dark Souls games. It makes no fucking sense. Like, they're in reverse order. Like, and Dark Souls 3 is rated, like, the worst of all the Dark Souls games. That doesn't make any fucking sense either, because this game is lovely. Except for one thing or two things about it that I'll go into later that honestly aren't that big of a deal. So, let's talk about our character here. Why the fuck am I playing a warrior? Why the fuck did I pick the fire gym? Why the fuck is Barney's meth-addled Walter White cousin attacking me right now? These are all important good questions that we should go over. But unfortunately, I seem to be too riddled with after-work, sleepy, lazy time to think straight. So I'm just gonna, like, wing it, maybe? And we'll get to one of those things at a time. First of all, let's not die against Mr. Meth Head here. Don't do meth. Meth is bad for you. It will make you not attractive to live. Oh god! I didn't mean to dodge that way. Oh, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me, I said. I am your master. I said I'm your master. Ow! I was hoping I could get him staggered with that one. So you know those crystal lizards from the first game that were, like, easy to kill, and you're like, fuck you, crystal lizard, hi, go fuck yourself. Oh, god damn it, I staggered him on that one, I just didn't hit him fast enough. Okay, well, that's nice, you do your thing. You do your thing. Oh, Jesus! Oh, Jesus! Oh, I'm so sorry. I got one more Estus, and if I can't kill this thing in one more Estus, I'm just... I quit. I'm not doing the playthrough. It's... I'm done. I'm actually, like, I'm serious. If I don't kill this thing, with the amount of health it's got left, I'm done! I'm not playing anymore! Go fuck yourself. That was almost a death. You almost didn't get the rest of your Dark Souls playthrough. That was how close it came. Just talking and playing same time is hard. Bitch, moan. Anyway, I'm glad that we get to continue with this playthrough, because it will be fun. We're gonna have fun. We're gonna do good. So, let's talk about what the fuck we are. We are Bloody Mary, the girl demon pink with a beard and eyeballs, and the reason we picked warrior is that little attunement stat right there. You remember attunement from Dark Souls 1, right? Attunement gives you more attunement slots. And the more attunement slots you have, the more spells you can do. Well, isn't that just amazing? We got how many attunements? 6? And how many attunement slots do we have? 0. Well, the Souls Builder on the website lied to me. But that's okay, because as it turns out, we don't fucking need attunement slots. Because we're a warrior. That means we're stupid and we don't give a shit. But, to be a little bit more explaining things in particular, attunement in this game, I can go over all the stats one by one, the different ones, not all of them, because that would be boring. Attunement gives you more FP, as well as more attunement slots. FP means fuck points, which let you fuck more. And I don't need fuck points, because I identify as an asexual. And if you identify as an asexual, you don't need to have sex with people. So my character, Bloody Mary, is not concerned with reproduction or engaging in sexual activity. This is why I have chosen to go with a luck build, because I won't need to use buffs or any other sort of magic-y type things that require attunement slots. Except for the ones I'll need with rings for stuff like Slowfall and things like maybe bosses that are weak to specific shit. I don't know. But we can handle that with rings. We can get attunement slots with rings. We're not really going to be using our weapon arts that much, except for maybe like buffing a little bit and maybe applying a Slowfall. So it's kind of pointless for us to have any attunement at all. And that's the reason we're not doing attunement. We are, however, on the other hand, for some crazy reason, putting points in this weird attribute called luck, which wasn't in any of the other games, as far as I know, except for Demon's Souls. I didn't play Demon's Souls, though, because it's It was beyond, above my time. It was before. It was the before time. Someone told me luck was in the before time, so I thought I'd mention that. But luck in this game is a very weird stat, and it scales with your weapons if they're special, particular types of weapons that we're going to end up using. And it also causes people to bleed more. And now you know why my character's named Bloody Mary. Because she's going to make people bleed. And that was also why I was making period jokes. Which weren't funny. And you should not have laughed at them. If you did laugh at them, you should add me on Telegram because we have the same sense of humor. Congratulations. I don't know why I did that. I meant to do that. There we go. This is the first boss. I remember dying to him a lot when I first played this game because I was an idiot and bad. This boss is easy. Watch me prepare to get hit by all of his attacks in quick succession. Because, you know, the curse of recording is that will happen. You're probably confused by me making noises. I keep going, "Hur." It's a little weird. Like, why am I doing that, you know? It's what's the deal with that? What's up with that? Well, I'll tell you, Mr. Friend. Ow. That did not... Okay. Please don't kill me. Please don't. Please don't. Please. 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 Okay. Okay. We're fine. This is good. Me. Oh god, shit, fuck you, god damn it, no, bad brownie, do the jump thing, it leaves you open to attacks, do the jump, Space Jam, Michael Jordan, go, do the Michael Jordan, thank you! Everybody get up, it's time to slam jam. I haven't died yet! Woo! Maybe I'm not as terrible as I thought I was going to be. I was worried about that for a minute. We've just been introduced to the hauling mechanic in this game. Pretty much prevalent in all the other Souls games I've played except for Bloodborne. Whenever you die, you lose all your souls. You know that. But in this game, whenever something cool happens, like you kill a boss or you eat an ember, you get kindled. And when you get kindled, you're like all fiery and whatnot. And you have more health. So it's like reverse hollowing, sort of. Like in the other games... Oh, shit, son of a bitch. In Dark Souls 1, when you die, you go hollow, I think. And that enables you to not be able to summon people. So, I think that's the only bad thing about being hollow. It's kind of the same thing in this game. When you're not kindled, you can't connect to other players, so you have to be kindled in order to do any sort of, like, co-op shenanigans. But there's also the health bonus, so it's really nice being kindled. And it doesn't feel like a bad thing to not be kindled, because for the first time... You can't go hollow in this game innately. A little weird. A Dark Souls game where you can't go hollow. That ties into the story. As we are an unkindled ash. And being an unkindled ash means that we failed to link the fire in a previous life of some sort. And that makes us shit. We are shit. We are absolute poop. And we are left to clean up the Lords of Cinder's mess. Bye, puppy. I know. I'm sorry. And that's kind of the general story gist, I guess. So we're currently on our way to Firelink Shrine. And we're going to take this coiled sword we got from Mr. Iudex Gundyr, first boss. And we're going to throw that bitch in the bonfire. And whatcha? Make a Firelink Shrine bonfire. Oh, this is Firelink Shrine, by the way. That's important. That's like, whoa, Firelink Shrine, that's the same place that's in the first game. Holy fuck. It, oh, it's parallels. Welcome Jesus. To the bonfire and kindle the Firekeeper. Oh, she's my waifu. Firekeeper waifu. Okay. First order of business, we're going to pump Dex all the way 16 for mysterious reasons. Woo!
Farewell, Ashen.
And then, after pumping Dex all the way to 16, we can go talk to some people. Actually, let's talk to her first. I know, you want to talk to Blacksmith. I know, I see him back there too. Ashen, don't get too excited, don't piss yourself. Or he's going to be last.
Ashen, to be unkindled is to be a vessel for souls. Sovereignless souls will become thy strength.
Yeah, I already know that. Yep. Seek last, motherfucker. Anyway, so all these thrones are empty because all the lords are being lazy assholes, except for this guy, who's
all that unkindled.
They're all surprised and whatnot to see us, and we're surprised to see him.
I am Lutlith of Corland. Look not in bewilderment as I say. I linked the fire long ago, becoming the Lord of Cinder. If substantiation be thy want, set thine eyes upon my charred corpse. This sad cadaver, no need to be coy. Have a closer look.
I don't got binoculars, though.
No style of...
Alright, anyway, so he's gonna be all like, you gotta go link all the fires, but, I'm still here, because I know eventually you're gonna link all the fires, and I'm lazy, I'd rather just be here, so do your thing. He's a cool guy. I like Ludlith Corlin, he knows what's up, so we're gonna leave him the fuck alone. Alright, so what we got? There's nothing down there just yet. Oh, right. Most important thing, you have to do it at the start of any playthrough of Dark Souls 3, completely strip. Completely strip ass naked. We are completely naked. We are naked, pink bearded lady. And we are going to do the most important thing you can do in the initial start of a Dark Souls 3 playthrough, which is... Damn it, no tree seed. Oh, by the way, that's the seed of a... you know what, Dark Souls 2, which you haven't played. Mechanics from Dark Souls 2. There are trees that give you seeds of a giant, and when you get the seed, you can use it, and it makes all the enemies in the world attack invaders. Now you're caught up. Yeah. Holy shit, I did it first try. Jesus Christ. I'm on a roll. Alright. I can put all my gear back on, I guess. I was honestly not expecting to do that in one attempt. Holy shit. That's a secret for you guys, by the way. Whenever you start a run of this game, you should do exactly what I'm doing right now. Which is being up here. A place you're not supposed to be able to get to yet. But you can use that magical shortcut I just showed you to get all the way the fuck up here. And do a look around.
You. Me, Pickle Pea. Me, Bumperum.
I love your birds! I love the birds!
That's an Estus shard. Guess what we gotta use that for? Not even gonna explain it. Visions of Illusion! Ha-cha! Illusionary wall in the first place! What the fuck's down here? Oh my god, it could be something amazing! It is something amazing! Holy shit! It's the Covetous Silver Curfew Ring! And it's the first ring you can get in the game if you know where the hell it is. Which most people don't. But now you do, because you watch my YouTube show, and thank you. I love you for sticking around me. And not abandoning me after I completely stopped making videos for a while. That was so nice of you to do that! You're the best. You're just the best. I love you. Alright, anyway, so we did that, we got a ring. We're gonna go pay a visit to a complete asshole now. who's probably going to kill me 10 million times because I'm not very good at Dark Souls. He's up here. His name is the Master. I could have been Doctor Who, and this would have been very epic and cool, but sadly I am not Doctor Who. I am just a lady with a beard. Ow, shit! Ow, shit! Oh, Jesus! Oh, God! Oh, it's already bad. Hi, the Master. Can you... Okay, let me... No! No, 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 Jesus! God, how did I kill you with this build last time? You're so ridiculous! What the... No! 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 Oh, holy sh... Oh, my God! Rawr! I'm strong. I'm gonna get you. I should go back inside and get more Estus, but... Run away! I got this. I know how to kill him now. You gotta bait his attacks. And when you bait his attacks... come on! Yes! 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 I did it. I'm spitting on my microphone. I'm sorry. He's got all that shit. Master's Attire, Uchi Katana. What? Excuse me? The Uchi Katana? This early in the game? I know. I know. It's pretty ridiculous. It's the fucking Uchi Katana. Why is it this early in the game? I don't know. Ask Miyazaki. He thought it was a good idea for some reason. Oh my God, I'm getting attacked. Don't. I've got an ember. I want to summon friends in the first zone. Crazy person. Which one's better? The one I'm using is probably better. Okay. Well, look at us. We already got Uchi Katana. What? Insane. What could we possibly do to be even more overpowered than we already are? Well, I'll tell you what. Let me tell you something about the build we're going with. We're gonna be using luck, which means we're not gonna have the scaling factors to make use of this Uchi Katana. Ah, I know. It sucks, right? Well, let me tell you something about that gift we started off with. We can take that fire gem, and we can shove it up our own asshole, and create the most badass, crazy weapon of destruction known to mankind. The Fire Uchi Katana. And we have just enough souls to make it happen. So, let me sit down, turn around. Let's go talk to Andre about gearing up and going to town. Well, hey, Andre. How you, buddy?
I am Andre. I serve at this shrine as a humble smith forging weapons. You're in search of the Lords of Cinder, I trust?
Yes.
A toilsome journey, I'd wager. You'll require good arms.
I have good arms.
Let me smith your weapons.
I got one. I am a smith. It's got a sword in it. Such as I got my one. Purpose. It's got a shield in it. I got two good arms. We're going to fuse this Uchi Katana, which some people would be like, don't do that. That's really stupid. But I'm going to tell you straight up, it doesn't fucking matter. Infuse this motherfucker with fire. Straight off the bat, Mega Fire Uchi Katana. You can't go wrong with having a Fire Uchi Katana this early in the game. You will wreck shit to death. It will cry and wish it was Donald Trump. It was so fucked up. Like, that's the most insane comparison I can probably make. So, look at just how ridiculous we are now. We are just rolling in shit. Yeah. Oh, hang on, I forgot to do something in Andre. God damn it. I need to talk to that guy, too. Don't let me forget, audience. Audience, you better tell me to go talk to that guy again. Just here. What? All right. Reinforce. There we go. We got four uses on our Estus Flask now. The way Estus Flask works in this game is a little particular, by the way. That Ash and Estus Flask we got earlier is used to refill your FP. Sadly, since we don't really use our FP for anything, we're probably not going to use the Ash and Estus Flask very much at all ever, as far as I'm aware.
That is good, wasn't he?
I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure we're not going to use it. So.
Pretty beaker.
Woohoo! Flip away, my friend! Okay. Hi, lady.
Ashen Perdue the Motola.
Yeah, I already did that. Can you level me up again? Oh, God. What can we do points in now? Vitality, 11. Strength dex, about the same. That's fine. Fine. Let's put some points in. We can basically just go Endurance and Vigor now. Considering we're going to be using the Fire Uja Katana for a while, like a fucking while, and we're also going to be using another weapon off and on whenever I feel like it. It's kind of like, yeah, we're not gonna worry with stats. We're not gonna have scaling factors on any of our weapons for the longest, and they're gonna do crazy way more damage as a result.
Ah, another one roused from the sleep of death. Well, you're not alone. We unkindled are worthless. Can't even die right. Gives me conniptions. And it have us seek the lords of Cinder and return them to their molding thrones. But we're talking true legends with the metal to link the fire. We're not fit to lick their boots.
Oh, he's so sad. He's so sad.
Yes, ask you to.
Wah, what a downer. I don't like that guy. His name's Hogwood. He is sad. Because that's his character trait. There's one of him in every single Souls game. All of them are just as depressing as the last and not worth talking about. So we're not going to talk about them. Unless they become relevant. In which case, I guess I will talk about them. Onward to the high something of Lothric. Whatever the fuck this is. High place. So, basically, the story. Because I don't think I really touched on the story very much, if at all. The world's fucked up right now. Because they're... The bell, or whatever the hell, hit the emergency, oh my god, the fire's about to go out button. All Lord Sinner are like, we already did this, fuck you, we're not gonna do it, except for Ludlith Corlin. Ludlith Corlin's like, the player's gonna be here in like 5 minutes, guys. Can you just, okay, never mind. So Ludlith's just like, fuck it. But the rest of them went to their own, like, special happy place. And, yeah. So they're all fucking off and being assholes somewhere else. Which leaves us to clean up their mess. So we are going to go clean up after them. Oh, these are purple signs. Purple signs are funny. Purple signs cause you to summon mad phantoms into your world. Mad phantoms are attackable. They can also attack enemies as well as you. People like to put those purple signs down right here next to the starting bonfire. I keep spitting on my microphone. Because they think new people are going to show up and be like, oh, friend, I'm going to summon them because I'm a complete idiot. So I'm, of course, going to summon this guy and just be like, hey, buddy. We're friends, and then I'm going to just turn around and kill him the second he does anything to me. Because he does not know who he is fucking with. I just got to find this guy first. I don't know where the hell he is. Also, it's nice to have someone for protection, just in case something bad happens. with this purple guy, which it might. Do, 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 do. Hi, purple guy. You're a good friend. You're a friend to me. We're going to be friends. Man, this is... Look at this. All this cooperation. Hello. How are you today? I forgot to get that gesture. Damn it.
Hello.
I could have gotten it. You can get that hey gesture from Snuggly the Crow. I totally, completely fucked that up. Oops, my bad. So we're not going to do that until later. The important thing to get from Snuggly was the whatchamadoohick. Ow. The Silver Covenant ring. The silver serpent. That thing, yeah. So let's go ahead and equip our binoculars because it's super awesome for something later. Alright. More jolly cooperation is at hand. This purple guy, I am so curious as to when they're going to make a move on me. Ah, sweet, a longsword. Yeah. Damn it, I didn't get a longsword in my last playthrough. Longsword's like my favorite weapon. One of my favorite weapons. But, for the purposes of being Bloody Mary, I've always got to use a bleed weapon. That's going to be my thing. And I'm going to try to do all the storylines on this playthrough just so you can see them. But, I don't know how well that's going to work out. I kind of tend to forget about shit because I'm forgetful. And, we'll just do the best we can with that, okay? I already know how to do the really important storylines, and that's all we're going to worry about for the moment. So, yeah, we'll figure that out as we go. Alrighty. Woohoo! Yay. Okay. Mimic. Mimic is a good time for this phantom to... Oh my god. I can't believe the phantom actually opened the treasure chest. I didn't think that was possible. Are you gonna do it? You killed the phantom. Shouldn't that be what you wanted? I'm really confused. I thought mad spirits, like, once they killed a phantom, they were, like, good to go. There's only... Oh my god. I am really confused right now. I have no idea what's going on. Anyway... you get the deep battle axe from that thing. I'll explain what that does as soon as we're to the next bonfire. I'm getting really nervous about being in this world by myself. Oh my god. Okay. Maybe the Mad Phantom's cool. You know? Never judge a... Oh shit! I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hit you. Never judge a book by their cover, you know? They could be friends. Could be nice. Perhaps, maybe, possibly. I'm seriously getting creeped out by this Mad Phantom being in this world with me. They're all dead. Oh, God! I think it's a cool Mad Phantom. I think they went ahead and they're clearing ahead for me. So maybe it's okay. Maybe they're friendly. Maybe it'll all be fine. Yeah, they seem cool. They seem all right. All right. Thank you for being kind and just being a nice person. That's good. I can't light this bonfire because you're here. I'm in combat, so yeah, I can't light it. It won't let me. I don't know why. I'm really nervous. I don't want to keep going. I don't trust this bad phantom, you guys. I'm really scared. Okay. We're just gonna keep going. I don't have any Estus, so I'm hoping you can just take point on this. Can please? All right. Well. Yeah. Damn it. All right. Oh shit. Whack it. There you go. Okay. Cool. Thank you for that. I'm going to continue clearing through here. Friend. Oh, sweet. I got an Estus back. Hooray. Okay. Alright. So, I'm going to pretend to be a newbie. Not know what the fuck I'm doing. I'm gonna be like, oh, it's locked. Oh, I didn't know that. It's acting like a newbie, maybe. We'll sedate the mad phantom so they do not want to puncture me in the butthole with their sword. That would be good for me not to die. So we're not gonna worry about that. There's a door over there. We'll go through there later. What really gets me is when Mad Phantoms also are like, they've got names that are blotted out because the content filter didn't like it. So there's multiple reasons I'm not feeling this guy. Ow! Pain and suffering. Wait a minute, is that a? Oh my god, I can summon. Please be a friend that can mitigate the Mad Phantom. Oh, holy shit. Did you do that just to piss me off? You summon that guy? Oh. You got a raw gem for me. Well, I guess that's okay. I guess I forgive you for that. Can you please? I know. You're being a dick. I'm not okay with it. Don't kill me! I'm sorry! Friend! Compadre! I'm so scared! Don't kill me, Mad Phantom! I'm so sorry! Thought this was gonna be cool! It's not cool! It's not cool anymore! Oh god! It was just the bow guy. Nothing. Oh my god! I'm playing like a. Please go. Please help. Please kill all that. Where the fuck is the other guy? Oh, I'm sorry. Get him. Get him. Thank you, okay. I don't have any Estus. I'm really not okay with this. Okay. I'm gonna run around. I'm just gonna run. I'm gonna run to the next shortcut. I don't want any of this. I'm so done. I don't have any Estus. I'm just gonna run to the next shortcut and get the fuck away from you and let you, you can do it. You do it yourself. Just stay the fuck away from me. I don't trust you. I want you to leave me the fuck alone. Bye. Bye. Apparently the other Phantom died. That's great. I don't know if she killed him to appease her wrath, her crazy mad, her crazy whatever nonsense wrath, but it doesn't matter because I'm back here. Behold, we have done a complete loop. Alright. I really want to rest at this bonfire now. We need to get Estus back. But this mad phantom is preventing me from doing so. God damn it. I almost want to puss out and die. But I'm not gonna. I'm gonna summon more friends. Maybe. Some more friends? Yes, okay. I swear, I'm just doing this out of sheer just, I need a bodyguard. I don't trust this person I've invited into my realm willy-nilly. I was talking all this good shit about, like, how I was gonna own them, and it's turned out they've turned the tables on me. They have more health than I do. I have no Estus. Okay. Headhunter Kato. You seem like a trustworthy sort. I will be happy. Yay. Okay. Are we good? All right, good. Okay. Just follow me, please. I don't know where the fuck that other phantom is. Ugh. Let's clear up here. I didn't go up here last time. You're a bat! Go away. Turns into one of those crazy monster things if you let those things go. Best not to just even bother with that. And I suppose the story with the corrupted critters, like the first boss was all corrupted, and all those random enemies are corrupted. I think the deal with them is that something to do with Aldrich, maybe. I don't remember really. Anyway, okay. There we go. You're dead. I'll be really surprised if this goes well. Come, Kato. You will protect me. Me, the no-flask Bloody Mary lady. Let's be... Oh god, there's more dudes down here than I remember. I know where they came from. I was just acting surprised for dramatic effect. Eh. They all, like, pop up over that wall over there. All, like, bleh, weird, creepy guys. Ooh. Spooky, scary. Ooh. Okay. Seriously, where the fuck did this purple guy go? I really don't know where they went. It's kind of bothering me. Yay, they're dead! Hooray! Hooray for me. Good for me. Okay. Right then. So now I'm just trapped down here at the Wing Knight. Okay. Well, I'm just gonna bail. Bye. Go up here. We need to get back to that other bonfire is what we need to do. And the way to get back to it is... oddly where I just was. I wasn't even thinking. Okay. Excuse me. Excuse me, pardon me, excuse me, excuse me, excuse me, don't kill me, excuse me, excuse me. Another raw gem, that's nice. Getting a lot of those. Raw gems are super nice. I don't think they give me as much scaling as the fire deep gems do at the moment, especially because all the fire and deep gems give you auxiliary effects. We're going to be using the deep axe we just got from that mimic on the first boss because I think it's weak to dark damage. Last time I fought Vordt and I had that thing on me, I wrecked his ass with the dark damage from that deep axe. And also, in addition, that deep axe is very good for killing all the night guys that are running around that are normally really annoying to kill. So, a little bit of both. We're going to make good use of that here in a second. I want to see if I can rest of this bonfire up here. We can finally get our shit back. There we go. Alright, there we go. Good. We can't rest at it. Sorry, Kato, you're gone. Bye. I need to level and upgrade my shit. Don't be super angry with me, please. Thank you. Okay, we're back. Ugh, we've already done so much.
Welcome,
let's talk to our best friend. And we can get some nice levels. And the stats we need to have levels in. And then we can talk to her.
A pleasure to make thine eye amb weapon.
Yeah. She's one of the old Firekeeper bitches from Dark Souls 2. You guys are gonna make me play that one day, aren't you? Yep, I know you are. Don't even try to deny it. It's alright, I don't hate you for wanting me to play that game. I'm just not looking forward to it when I actually do it, and I'm probably gonna try to Shanghai Voldex into playing it with me. Because I don't want to go about it myself. Y'all. Alright. We're going to make that into a deep battle axe plus one.
Be careful.
Which is a little weird considering I haven't been using the battle axe at all. But just trust me. I want to do more damage to the enemies that are going to do more damage to me. So we're going to basically be upgrading our deep battle axe and our fire uchi katana. Off and on a little bit. I think I'm not sure if I'll use the deep battle axe very much past Vordt, but it's very good on Vordt, so I'm gonna put some points into it at least. I feel like I've already been recording for a really long time. Wasn't expecting to do this much today. Okay, anyway. We're back at the high wall. We're gonna go... actually, can we summon someone else to help us clear this area? Well, howdy doody! We sure can. We can summon Jake and whoever the fuck that was and whoever the fuck that was. Please assist me. Friends. Oh. No. Not again. No more purple spirits. Ain't happening. Can't make me. Not worth the stress. The last one I summoned really stressed me the fuck out. Okay. We're gonna keep using this fire thing. It seems to have a better effect on corpse-like enemies, enemies that burn easily. I know. It's kind of hard to understand why that is, right? But that's the thing. So for now, I'm gonna be using the Suchi Katana a lot on all these hollowy, corpsey mobs. Die. And die. Cool. Oh god! No. Stabbed in your butt! Okay. Our gold is what's directly underneath us for now. We're gonna take a little bit of a detour on the way to the next boss. No! Shit. I fucked it up. I wasn't thinking, slash was being an idiot, and as a result, this is what's happening. And it's all my fault. I did this to myself. But the good news is, this particular monster is very susceptible to fire if you can actually hit it without getting killed. Which we may not be able to do because I might be bad. Oh my god, I might be bad. Please die. Thank you, Jesus. We got Titanite Shard, that's good. Maybe we can put one point into our Jigatana before we go much further. I'm getting so many raw gems. What the fuck? I'm not complaining. That's just an unusual amount of raw gems. Raw gems are really nice for the starter character that is starting off that has absolutely no stats budget at all. Ha! You thought you would kill me, didn't you? No. Silly goose. Okay. So to demonstrate what I mean, the knight in here, I'm going to try to kill with my Jigatana first. Just to give you an idea of kind of how annoying they are. The knights in this game wear very heavy armor and ergo have a lot of poise. So, man. They are really hard to stagger. And it kind of sucks not being able to stagger them. They do a shit ton of damage. Especially later. Like when you fight the ones that are later in the game. God damn it. So, just for the sake of showing you how this works, I'm gonna fight this guy a little bit with my Uchi Katana. And maybe I can at least hit him once. Ow. There we go. It was a critical, but whatever. It did okay amounts of damage, I guess. But not a ton. However, if I switch to my other weapon and go after those knights, it does a lot more, I think. Suddenly, I'm not as sure of that. I might have been talking bullshit. Okay, you're gonna have to bear with me. I don't know as much about this game as I seem to. Just calm down. Don't judge. I'm just... all of the things I know about this game are from trial and error suffering through my first playthrough, okay? So, if I say something and I'm all like, dirt to dirt to dirt to dirt, and it sounds like I know what the hell I'm talking about, take it with a grain of salt until I'm like, okay, you should really definitely do this. Like the Silver Covenant Ring thing. I don't know why I keep calling it that. The Silver Serpent Ring thing. Yeah, you should definitely do that. Like you start any new game. That's kind of obvious. I don't think I need to explain why. I mean, just you get so many more souls. I mean, like, I've leveled up a million, billion, jillion, zillion times as a result of that. It's the biggest awesome thing you can do for yourself in Dark Souls, outside of buying life insurance. But they don't offer life insurance in Dark Souls, so... Yes, they do! I lied. Ring of Sacrifice. They do. So, you can always buy life insurance. especially in Dark Souls 2 when the Ring of Sacrifice was completely broken and overpowered. We'll get into that later when I play Dark Souls 2. If I play Dark Souls 2, maybe. Don't hold your breath. Burn, 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 burn. How to get burned? How to get burned? I think I made him bleed, actually. That's what did that extra damage. I gotta remember that Yuji Katana does have a little bit of a bleed effect. A little bit of a bleed. That's gonna be another Estus shard on that anvil. Reach on this thing is so fucking awesome. Oh my god. The Yuji Katana is just like, oh. I don't know why the hell they decided to give this weapon to us this early in the game, because, just everything you hit with it's just like, fuck! Oh my god, Yuji Katana, what? Why? Why have you done this to me? Why have you, oh man, all the dogs on fire, so it instantly rolls over and it's all sad. Oh my god, Fire Yuji Katana is like the best thing ever. It's almost as good as Lunchables. Fire Yuji Katana is like it's a little bit less good than Lunchables, maybe. That's heresy. No, forget what I just said. Yuji Katana definitely better than Lunchables. It's whoa, just you'd have to be an insane crazy person not use this sword through at least the first little like area of the game. It's so ridiculously good. For just starting off, because of the bleed effect and the range, so much damage. So dumb. You know, be whatever build you want, as long as it's got 16 dexterity, you can use the damn thing. You're gonna freaking go crazy bonkers on every single mob you could possibly want. So, good stuff. Alright. I'm gonna go after this Wing Knight with this deep battle axe we just upgraded here. I have no idea how it's gonna go just yet. And I don't know how he was still alive, but. Ow, 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 fuck. Stop. I'm doing a lot of damage to these things with the deep battle axe. Maybe they're not as immune to it as I thought. Maybe I am completely full of shit! Oh, no, maybe I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about at all. No, that would be terrible. What was actually expected? Bar for the course. Yeah. All right. I don't have any Estus. This guy is going to wreck my shit. Okay. Okay. Eh. Okay. Well, it's helping having look at all that damage. Oh my god. Bro, you don't even know about my 100% block shield I just picked up randomly and forgot was 100% block shield until 2 seconds ago. Oh boy, this might have actually saved my ass unexpectedly. All right. Well, I'm going to Kamehameha. And then I'm gonna... Because you're fat. Get spanked! Good shit. Alright. We have done a good job. Eh. All right. A smart man would go back and get more Estus. Unfortunately for me, I am ballsy, and I am going to summon help due to my lack of Estus to try to get through this next area. Because I don't know why there were 2 summon signs right there. They were conveniently placed, and I want to see if they can help me on my quest. Hi, Lion Knight Alp. Is that an NPC? Phantom. Is his name 117? That's actually his name? Okay, well. That's obviously a player. Backstab him. Thank you. Alright. Can you fellas get this guy too for me, please? Thank you. Yeah, yeah. Good, 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 good. Service me, my minions. More Titanite shards. Why is the game giving me so many Titanite shards? That's kind of awesome. But it's a little weird. And I'm going to butt slap you. My god, all the damage. Hoo-ah! Bitch. Alright. That was a healing noise. Oh my, oh, never mind. He pulled the blue knight. I was gonna stop for a second and admire his awesome armor. What the fuck? Okay, never mind. Ah! I'm backstabbed. He's normally an asshole. But by the power of friendship, we have bested him. Die. Die, friend. He's such an asshole normally. That guy takes me like 10 hours to kill. Okay. Well, we're in the cathedral type place. There's a lady here. She's been waiting for us for a while. Her name is Emma, and she's like, all your friends are gone. You need to go chase them with the banner. And if you're scared of people, you can use this covenant symbol to be a bitch. So I'm totally going to be scared of people, so I'm totally going to... I can't because I've summoned guys. I forgot about that. Oh, well. All right, Albert, let's go. I'm not gonna kill that lady. Stop looking at me like that. I hope he wasn't expecting me to kill that lady, because I don't want to kill that lady. That lady's nice. She gives you an awesome covenant to join. So I want to fight this boss with two friends summoned and no Estus. Hell yeah. Two friends summoned, no Estus. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Let's make this shit happen. I'm also getting a phone call, but I'm gonna ignore it. This is more important. It's plot. Dear Jesus. What is that? It's a giant glowing fart. It would have to be made by a creature with a giant ass. Oh, giant ass monster. Oh, you think I'm kidding? Just waiting for this thing to turn around. I am not joking. This monster's ass is so big. It's the size of the friggin' sun. Where the hell is it? Oh, there it is. Hi. What the? You're teleporting. You can't do that. That's Doctor Who's ability. Lionite Albert, can you? Okay, thank you. I'm gonna buff myself really quick. Oh, God. Hit it! Whack it! Whack it! Hit it good! Alright, back up. Let's get some stamina. We're gonna, okay, be careful. He's doing his flips! Holy crap! He's Mr. Flippy! Look out for Mr. Flippy! He's gonna get you! Oh, Jesus Christ! Whack! Whack! I will be impressed if I actually manage to kill this thing without taking a single hit. I totally killed it without taking a single hit. I know I had people summoned, but that's still impressive. Don't judge me! I'll play the game how the fuck I want. Goodbye, Phantom 117. You get 1 point. Goodbye. Alright. That was eventful. Bonfire lit! Still haven't died yet. Kind of playing like a pussy, that's probably why. I'm gonna just take my Uchi Katana and I'm gonna go upgrade it now and maybe spend some souls or something, I don't know. Anywho, I've done a lot of talking, my voice is starting to crack. I think we're going to be done for now. Hopefully, this was at least slightly entertaining for somebody. Dark Souls 3 playthrough taken very, very not seriously on the incoming. Kind of just because I can't stop playing it, and I figured might as well take through it with me.
Well, Matt, just good to see you. Wasn't he?
Thanks, buddy. Let's reinforce our weapon as much as we can. Let's crank this Uchi Katanas. That's okay.
Be careful.
So one upgrade, got it. Right, because I gotta upgrade the other one. We need to buy things from you. We can get that. Cool. Okay. We're gonna go ahead and add these two things to our, yeah, it's fine. We're gonna add these two things to our tool belt. White Sign Soapstone and the Dried Fingers. I'll explain what those do as soon as I use them.
Welcome home, I should speak then. Very well.
And what kind of level ups can we do with you? Let's go one point there. I'll just keep that rolling for now. There's not really any need for us to boost luck at this exact moment. So we're not going to... We'll do that later. Not right now. Spend 494 souls and level up? Yes, I will do that. Hooray!
May the flames.
Thank you. Alright, this has been the start to Bloodborne. I'm done, bye! Fuck it. Done. I quit. I'm done. I'm deleting this character. I'm turning off the stream and deleting this character. It's gone. This character's gone. Bye. This character. I'm done. I'm deleting it. You think I'm kidding? You think I'm kidding, don't you? Hang on. No. I'm not kidding. I'm not. It's going. I'm doing it. I'm deleting the character. You watch your ass. Hang on. It's happening. This character's, it's going away. Load game. And fuck this character. Bye. Oh, wait. I got the wrong one. You live another day, Bloody Mary! I swear to God, you will pay for your crimes of being pink for some reason and also having red eyes. You will rue the day! And whatnot. I remember when I was funny. That was some good times, wasn't it?